Welcome, Kira. Welcome, Louise.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. That was a fabulous piece of dancing there. Tell me, how long have you been doing this type of dancing?
I've been dancing for 24 years now, and I think I've been dancing for about 17.
But of course, when you first started dancing, it was the traditional Irish dancing that you started, wasn't it?
That's right, yes. We were both only really young when we first started Irish dancing, and it was the traditional competition style Irish dancing that we did.
Yeah.
And then for the past 14 years, I've been in Celtic Beat from when it first started.
That's right, yeah.
Which takes a more modern twist on Irish dancing and adventure.
Yeah, it's very different to the traditional dancing stuff, isn't it? And it's a lot more artistic as well, isn't it?
Yeah, the choreography that's involved in it is taken from other dance style influences.
That's right. And a lot of hard work goes in preparing the programme, doesn't it? Because there's a lot in there, isn't it?
Yeah. It's not just the standard on a line with your arms straight kind of thing that we do. It's, you know, looking at different movements and ways to be that bit different.
Yeah, and it's very artistic. You put a lot of different things in, don't you? A lot of different styles, and you bring those all together. It's very exciting. Obviously, you must have to work very hard, pair of you.
Yeah, very hard. A few times a week.
And so you've been doing this type of dancing now for 14 years?
I've been in Celtic Beat for 14 years.
Right.
I've had two different dance partners.
When did you join the team, Louise?
I think it was about 3 years ago now.
Right.
Yeah, about 3 years. And
you get on very well, obviously.
Oh yeah, we're like sisters, aren't we?
Yeah. Known us for a long time.
Yeah, but I know that you travel long distances, don't you, to venues. You travel all over the place, don't you?
Yeah, we dance all over England, Scotland. Yeah.
And you've been abroad as well.
We have.
Times, haven't
you? Yeah, we've been to Malaga on the Enjoy Travel.
Yeah.
Week over in Malaga, and. Up and down England, Ireland, Scotland, all over the place, really.
And you get massive crowds, of course, wherever you go, don't you?
Yeah, we do a lot of festivals and things like that, and you tend to get the big crowds. Several thousand at those that we do, the outdoor things.
And
over
so
the
you've
summer.
Actually been seen by a massive audience, haven't you, really, throughout the UK as well?
Yeah.
And so how far can you take this then?
Well,
I mean, you're introducing new dances all the time, of course, and you're freshening the act, aren't you?
I think what our aim is to do, I mean, obviously Michael Flatley's come out with the River Dance and the Lord of the Dance, which has put a different spin onto Irish dancing and the way that people see it, you know.
Yeah.
Sometimes when people don't know, they think you dance around with bells and things, you know, and it's only when they actually watch it that they get quite fascinated by it. But I think what we do is we take it to a different level above that and bring in like influences of street dancing, modern, tap, and it kind of, we're quite eclectic in what we do.
And I think since this type of dancing has been done, Irish dancing has become, I suppose, more interesting, hasn't it, really?
Yeah, definitely. It's become really, really
and
popular.
And I suppose appeal to a bigger audience as well.
Yeah, I think that since Riverdance there was a big influx of people wanting to learn Irish dancing, and it's just growing and growing. I mean, the competitors that take part in the championships and things like that, these thousands and thousands travel over to Ireland each year for the World Championships of Irish dancing, so it just shows how popular it has got.
Louise, is it very tiring then when you've done a night's performance? Is it a very tiring exercise after you've finished?
Yeah, very tiring, but a lot of practice goes into it, so...
Yeah. So you deal with it.
Yeah, you have to.
Yeah.
You push yourself, don't you?
Yeah.
It does get sometimes where you are at the end and you just get that you get your energy from the crowd, really, when you get into that last bit, and it is getting tough if you've got the audience with you. Mm. It gives you that adrenaline.
Now, aside of the Celtic Beat and the dancing, of course, you're a teacher as well, aren't you?
Yes. We do teach together as well. That gives us an idea of, again, how popular the Irish dancing has become, because the children come through the door. And
now, are you teaching your type of dancing, or are you teaching the traditional Irish dancing, firstly?
We start them off with the basic things. You know, Louise does a lot with the littler ones, don't you? And sets them off.
A lot of traditional first, isn't it?
Just to get the basic things, the basic movements and the timing
as well.
And
then I suppose you'll find some of the kids would be quite good and will come on quicker. So you'd be looking at them then to perhaps bring them into the type of stuff that you're doing with the Celtic Beat scene.
Yeah, definitely. You know, every child learns at their own level. They all progress in their own way. Yeah. Right. But then, like you say, you do get some that really do stand out that then you can show the different things that we do and move
And do you
them
enjoy
on.
Teaching, both of you?
Yeah, it's really good. It's rewarding, isn't it?
Yeah. I suppose it is rewarding when you see some of your little pupils coming on over the years and seeing how they do.
Yeah, because when they first walk into that dance class, you know, and they're trying to skip around in a circle and then to see them actually perform some technical steps, it's really rewarding.
And so what's the future hold now for Celtic Beat, because you're busy, of course, up and down the country in festivals and the concerts and dances. What does the future hold for you?
Well, we just want to carry on doing what we do, and you know, I think while you enjoy it, I always remember Michael Flatley saying, and I quote, that, you know, if you've got a show that you'll do for nothing, for nobody, then you've got a good thing going on, and we're the same as that. You know, when we practice like we're dancing for 10,000 people, you know, as hearts are in it. So while that's still the case, we'll just carry on and enjoy doing what we do.
And you'll do the same, you'll continue on?
Yeah, I'll be there.
And so do you ever argue?
Oh, we have a little tiffs over who's wearing what and how much makeup we should have on and things like that.
But nothing too serious.
No, nothing.
And the costume, who designs your costumes? Because, you know, they're quite smart as well, aren't they?
Yeah, we...
Do you have an input in that, then?
Not really. It's mostly you, isn't it, that thinks of the idea. I just tell them what I don't like.
Right. So you're the influence behind the costumes, then?
Yeah, I'll get an idea. Like, one of the pieces that we do is to tell me ma. So, you know, the first thing you think is children in a playground. So we went for the school uniforms and we use skipping ropes as the props and things like that, and the dances have their own choreography and their own style to them. Like, we do a country and western number to Cotton Eye Joe and you know, we...
So you pick the uniform for the different styles of dancing?
Yeah, and just try and be
and of course bit. you're a great little dancer yourself on the dance floor. I've seen yourself and Ryan, is it? two great dancers on the dance floor.
Yeah, we like to get out there and have a jive once we've come off stage and let our hair down a bit, don't we?
Great. So. Well, listen, thanks very much, girls, for coming on. The best of luck to you for the future. And no doubt we'll see you up and down the country at festivals again.
Yes, definitely.
Thank you very much, Louise.
Thank you.
And Ciara, thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.